Hello YouTube. Today I'm going to show you how to delete wireless profiles. In my case, I've accumulated quite a few wireless profiles because I had a hidden wireless network that I was connecting to, and in doing so, you have to manually add the connection each time, and when you do that, it just creates a copy of the network with the number 2 on the end, and then the number 2-3, and then the number 2-3-4, and so on and so forth. And so the end result is I have all of these Gohan networks. And you might also have something similar, or maybe you just want to delete a wireless network that you connected to before and you don't want your computer to automatically try and connect to it, say maybe an AT&T Wi-Fi or a public Wi-Fi, anything along those lines, that you accidentally checked that connect automatically box. So in Windows 8, there is no graphical way to do this. It all has to be on the command line. Don't let that scare you. I'm going to walk you through it step by step. And I would also recommend that if you do have a wireless network of your own, that you no longer hide the network name. That may have at one time been considered a security feature, but no longer is that the case. There's an article on Microsoft that I'll link to in the description that talks about exactly why that is no longer considered a security feature. And it's really just going to cause yourself more trouble and doesn't prevent the hacker from getting on at all. So check out that link if you don't believe me, but I definitely recommend you show your network name. It's going to make things a lot easier for yourself. So let's get started. Oh, I'm also going to post the code for this that we'll be typing in the description as well. So let's begin. In the bottom left, if you're on 8.1, we're going to click on the start button. We're actually going to right click on it. If you're on Windows 8, you're going to want to move your mouse into the very bottom left corner until the little Start button appears, and then right-click on that. And we're going to go Command Prompt Admin. We're going to say yes to this little window that pops up here. And we're going to be using the netsh command to do this. And let's take a look at those profiles one more time. So I'm going to do netsh wlan, which is wireless local area network, show profiles. And so here they are again. As you can see, there are a bunch of Gohan connections here that I'm going to get rid of, and I'm also going to get rid of these extra Miten connections. And so the way we're going to do that is with the netsh command, wlan delete profile. We're going to put this in quotes, and it's going to be Gohan space star, end quote. And the reason I put a star after Gohan is that's considered a wild card, and what that means is not only will it remove Gohan 2, but it will remove Gohan 3, 4, anything that could possibly match here, including multiple characters, will be matched for this. So it's going to delete any Gohan profile. And we'll go ahead and hit enter. And there it goes. It also lists the interface. If you have multiple Wi-Fi devices, it might list more than what you see here. But there you go. All those profiles have been deleted. Let's do that one more time for the Miten. I'm just going to hit up on my keyboard and change Gohan to Miten. And there they go. And just to prove that they're really gone, we'll show profiles one more time. Files, and there they are. So, as you can see, the original Gohan network is still there because I put the space and then the wildcard. So that means any Gohan network that included a space and anything after that, which means numbers. So the original network was not deleted. If I hadn't put that space in there and had just done Gohan star, it would have deleted the original network as well. So keep that in mind. Not that big of a deal. You can always reconnect to it again and save it back to your list of profiles here. But that is what I wanted to do, and that's what happened. So if you have any questions, I'll do my best to answer them in the comments, and also leave any suggestions for my next video. I'm going to try and do a series here of how-to videos on Windows 8, Windows 8.1. I can also do Windows 7. I can actually go all the way back to Windows 2000 if you really need to know how to do something on Windows 2000. If there's enough demand for any older version of Windows, I can also make a dedicated video explaining how to do that. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.